When John Wyndham wrote The Day of the Triffids, he surely thought his work was speculative fiction.
Like, look, they're everywhere. It's such a healthy tree, like, you know.
But as it happens, real-world plants can be just as lethal as those in the legendary dystopian novel. These are the most deadly plants on Earth. Number 15. Nepenthes Raja. The idea of the carnivorous plant has long been a popular trope of science fiction, but did you know that it's actually a very real thing? Much like the plant in Little Shop of Horrors, researchers discovered a giant plant that loves to eat live animals. Researchers discovered this 4-foot-tall plant at the top of Mount Victoria in the Philippines, after a group of Christian missionaries previously reported it to a local newspaper. The plant is apparently the second largest pitcher plant anywhere in the world, and attracts its victims by secreting nectar around its mouth. When the insects and rats are lured in, the plant strikes and secures a delicious meal in the process. Everybody wins, except for the animals, of course, which are dead in seconds. This plant is just one of three in the world recorded as having killed mammalian animals, though no humans have been listed among them yet. Audrey II had to get a human friend to feed him the blood he desperately wanted, but this plant can find its own food without assistance. And of course, while no human deaths have been recorded just yet, there's always time. Dentists beware. Like this video, smash the subscribe button, and click the notification bell right now, or this centipede will crawl on your face when you're sleeping. Now it's time for the juicy topic. The Venus flytrap is one of the most legendary plants of all time, known for luring flies in and trapping them within its colossal snapping mouth. But its snapping and catching is not random. These plants are actually calculating hunters. In order to survive in the nutrient-poor soils of the savannas and bogs they call home, the Venus flytrap has evolved from humble plant to meat-eater. They emit a fruity scent that lures in fat insects, eager for a taste. Once the fly is within its grasp, the plant snaps its jaws, sometimes as swiftly as about 1/10 of a second. They are now so evolved that they can even tell the difference between a fly landing on them and a raindrop. As always, comment down below with the hashtag #JuicyTopic and let us know your opinion in relation to what we just showed on screen. Let's move on to the next one. Number 14. Yew trees. Yew trees are among some of the most toxic trees anywhere on the planet. And unfortunately for us, there are a lot of different types. European yews, Pacific yews, Canadian yews, Chinese yews, I could go on. In summary though, they're trying to kill us and they have an army to do so. If ever they declare war, we're basically dead. The only part of the yew tree that is not toxic,
suppose it grows on limestone ground. Lime soil
is the fleshy part around the seed. Everything else, meanwhile, is very harmful. In fact, there have been recorded cases of cattle and horses dying after consuming some poisonous leaves. So maybe there's a good reason that there's no such thing as a yew salad. Suppose you were to consume the leaves of the yew tree. In that case, you'd suffer a series of increasingly unpleasant side effects, from vomiting and diarrhea to muscle tremors and incoordination, or even death. Unfortunately, there is no known cure for the effects of yew tree poisoning, even if you did survive. The yew tree is one of the most dangerous trees on the planet, with just about every single part capable of causing death. Let this be a warning for those of you that like to consume random plants. Just eat a regular salad. Number 13. Deadly nightshade. If a plant has the word deadly in its name, chances are that it's not just a marketing tactic. The deadly nightshade is one of the world's most famous toxic plants, and its reputation is very well earned. Just 3 berries are enough to kill a human child. For adults, anywhere between 10 and 20 berries.
They've occasionally been used as recreational drug.
Chewing on a leaf, also death. So if you were entertaining any notions that this famously fatal plant was just overhyped, you could now put them to bed. If you're lucky enough to survive your consumption of deadly nightshade, you better hope that you're close to a hospital. Side effects can include anything from delirium to hallucinations and even muscle paralysis. The bottom line is, if you're not near a hospital, it's probably going to get much worse. And it's not just humans. Cats and dogs can also die from ingesting this plant. So don't think you're immune, Scooby-Doo. Deadly nightshade gets its name for a reason. It is potentially fatal. At this point, only a fool would think it a good idea just to have a taste. Don't be a fool and heed our warnings. Eat some lettuce. Number 12. Castor bean. We all know that traditional medicine often relies on some, shall we say, unusual ingredients. These are things that we would never, in any other circumstance, consider consuming. For instance, the castor bean, one of the most toxic ingredients on the planet. The castor bean contains something called one of the most toxic substances known to man. Depending on the number of castor beans consumed, the side effects can range from acute and potential gastroenteritis to delayed visceral damage. Because many of those using castor beans for traditional medicine are unaware
castor bean seeds in here too, and you see that they have grown up
of their ricin content, many have suffered these devastating effects. And, as with many plant-based toxins, there is no known cure for the poisoning. So what I'm trying to say is, don't do it. You'll really only have yourself to blame when you end up in the emergency room trying to explain why you ate the magic beans. Nobody in the right mind wants to experience this kind of severe gastroenteritis. With its high ricin content, the castor bean is most definitely one of the deadliest plants in our world. Not something to cook with then. Number 11. Rosary pea. If you've ever traveled, it's almost certain that you will at some point have come into contact with one of these. In fact, you may have one in your house right now. But you shouldn't be too concerned unless you or a family member have a habit of just eating anything you find. In that case, you should be very concerned. The rosary pea is a unique red seed with a black dot, often used to make jewelry and toys. While the plant as a whole is toxic,
another time, another place, we're talking about this right here.
The beans in particular are especially poisonous to humans. If you were to consume one, you could look forward to nausea and vomiting at best. And at worst, well, you probably wouldn't be doing much for the rest of your life. I can tell you that. The plant is considered an invasive species in the US, with most of the seeds coming to the country from foreign-made goods like toys and jewelry. So again, I must implore you to stop eating whatever you find in your house. It will kill you. Number 10. Water hemlock. And would you believe it? Here we found the most toxic plant in North America. And how do we know it's the most toxic? Well, because it can poison livestock or humans with a teeny tiny amount of cytotoxin. Let me explain. Cytotoxin is a violent convulsant that targets the central nervous system. When enough of this toxin gets into the body, the victim will begin suffering grand mal seizures and potentially even death. Most of this toxin can be found in the tubers, the leaves, the stem, and, well, it's pretty much in the whole plant. I think the lesson here is that just to stay away from this plant. Just go and look for some sunflowers or daisies or something. I don't know, it might extend your life by 40 to 50 years.
It'll move to the area in the body where it's needed most, which is very cool. So if you're taking it internally.
The water hemlock is a beautiful sounding plant, but boy, is it fatal. While it may smell like carrots, one bite of this and you'll never again be able to see. Let alone in the dark, you may as well just wave goodbye to your life or the cattle who knew better than to eat this plant, because they will outlive you. Number 9. White snake root. Admittedly, white snake root sounds exactly like something that could kill you, so if you decide to go biting into it, you may have it coming. Snake root poisoning is caused by one substance known as trimethyl, which isn't as fun as it sounds, trust me. What usually happens is that a cow will come along, take a bite of the plant, and develop an unusual symptom known as trembles. If it's a severe case of poisoning, the cattle will eventually develop convulsions and likely die. For humans, the process is pretty similar, but possibly worse. Human poisoning is often known as milk sickness and usually results from consuming the milk of a poisoned animal. The symptoms can be as mild as a loss of appetite and nausea to something as serious as the convulsions mentioned earlier and, yes, death. So in summary, Trematol, not fun. White snake root is not the kind of plant that people would just willingly go around biting into. It's usually a trickle-down poisoning effect, which arguably is even less fun. You don't want to die because you drank some bad milk. That's just... I mean, nobody wants that on their grave. Number 8. Tobacco. I don't think I have to do too much explaining here, right? Tobacco is one of the most famous deadly plants anywhere in the world, killing over 480,000 Americans every single year. That means 1 in 5 deaths in the US is caused by smoking. That's right, viewer. Put the cigarette out. Statistically, it makes no sense why anybody would subject themselves to a life of cigarette addiction. Smoking cigarettes kills more Americans per year than alcohol, car accidents, guns, and drugs. Around half of all smokers who continue the habit will die due to the long-term damage inflicted upon the lungs, mouth, skin, eyes, bones, blood vessels, reproductive organs, and heart. Basically, tobacco is toxic to every single part of your body. And yet people still think it's cool, or whatever the TikTok slang is nowadays. Tobacco is arguably the most toxic plant anywhere in the world. Without a doubt, it kills more people than any other. Still, people will continue to smoke their life away because... well, I don't know why, but I think we all wish them well. Sure, we'll go with that. Number 7. Oleander. Like most toxic plants, every single part of the oleander is considered to be poisonous. In fact, the plant is considered so toxic that you can get severely ill just by drinking water from the vase. Although that does raise the question of why people are drinking water from the plant vase, but I guess that's for another time. Regardless of whether it's fresh or dried, oleander is highly toxic. Thankfully, very few humans have ever died from consuming the plant, mainly because very few humans have ever consumed it. The incredibly unpleasant taste usually means that humans tend to avoid eating it, though the same can't be said for our animal pets. Dogs, cats, horses, cows, even birds have been known to eat the oleander and die shortly after, regardless of how much they may have eaten. It turns out that even a small amount is too big an amount. Anybody who consumes the oleander, or that consumes anything that may have touched it, will almost definitely die. Thankfully, there is a way to avoid death by oleander. Just don't eat the plants or anything it touches. Isn't that a wild idea? Also, stop drinking water from plant vases. That's gross. Number 6. Lily of the Valley. Here we have another famously toxic plant, and one in which all of its parts are, once again, poisonous. This one plant contains over 30 cardiac glycosides, enough to cause severe problems for your beating heart. And what happens if the heart can't pump? You can almost hear the flatlining, can't you? Generally speaking, the lily of the valley primarily affects children and pets, though there may have been instances where grown adult men have been brought down by this plant. Once the plant has been ingested, symptoms may begin small and mild, a stomach ache, some blurred vision perhaps. Over time, side effects can grow more severe, to the point of real concern, with vomiting, diarrhea, heart arrhythmia, seizures, and even death. And of course, being a poisonous plant, there's not much that can be done to treat the toxins. So again, try and limit your exposure to this homicidal plant. The lily of the valley is no joke. It's classified a 1 on the poison scale, the highest level, determining its toxicity as so major that it can lead to death. If ever there was a warning for you to just stay the hell away from a plant, this has to be it. Until they learn to sing anyway, then they can just sing Hotel California and nobody will go anywhere near it. Number 5. Rhubarb leaves. Pretty much all of us have, at one time or another, experienced the taste of rhubarb. But I bet you never knew how close you were to potential death, right? Well, that's a bit of a stretch, but I guess not a massive one.
Fertilizer on it so that it's ready to take off for spring.
Rhubarb leaves are known to be highly inedible, containing a high concentration of oxalic acid, a naturally occurring substance found in many plants and vegetables. However, too much oxalic acid can be dangerous, often leading to a condition known as hyperoxaluria, in which excess oxalate is released through the urine. That can lead to kidney stones, which then can lead to kidney failure. And as if that's not bad enough, you have additional side effects like nausea, vomiting, diarrhea, cramps, muscle twitches. Altogether, it just does not sound like my idea of a fun time at all. Rhubarb stalks also contain some of this oxalic acid, though far less than that of the leaves. If you're going to eat any part of the rhubarb, better stick with the stalk and leave the leaf behind. You see what I did there? Some wordplay, guys? You guys are so hard to please sometimes. Number 4. Foxglove. Sometimes even the most beautiful plants can be deadly. The foxglove is an American plant, often cultivated in private gardens to look all pretty. But of course, there's a twist. Every single part of this plant is incredibly poisonous. If I were to sum up what exactly is going on with this plant, it comes down to this. If you were to take any part of the plant and eat it, you're basically taking a hefty old dose of heart medication. Maybe your heart rate will slow down, or perhaps it will suddenly become irregular. Either way, it can be incredibly dangerous and put you in severe danger of death. Naturally, children are usually the ones that are drawn to the plant, thanks to its colorful bell-shaped flowers and berries. So for all you parents, keep an eye on your kids. The toxins in the foxglove are often used to create heart medicine, though of course that's usually reliant on a precise dosage. To just take a bite of the plant in the wilderness is, how do I put it, asking for trouble. But at least you'll be killed by something pretty. That's always better than eating a nail or falling into a puddle or something. Number 3. Wisteria. If you're a fan of gardening or plants, you'll probably know the wisteria as that long, snaking plant that almost always is wrapped around something. But did you know that it's extremely toxic? Probably not. Well, consider this your full warning.
This is the vine of a wisteria, and it got cut.
Every part of the wisteria is toxic, thanks to a saponin called wisterin. When ingested, this poison can cause dizziness, confusion, nausea, speech issues, diarrhea, and collapse, to name but a few side effects. Needless to say, even an accidental dosage of this can prove to be incredibly dangerous for the unsuspecting victim. One infamous tale details a 50-year-old woman who ingested 10 seeds, believing that they would be edible. Her symptoms were pretty brutal and lasted a full week after the incident, including one severe case of gastroenteritis and hematemesis. If you don't know what those are, just know they're not very good. Wisterias may look pretty and nice, but they absolutely should not be consumed under any circumstances. You don't want to be killed by a pretty plant. That's the ultimate killer of your cool status. Number 2. Dieffenbachia. Sadly, it's not a German-baked treat. Dieffenbachia is just a very elaborate name for the plant, also known as dumb cane. And why is it called that? Because when ingested, the plant's poison can temporarily cause difficulties speaking in the victim. It quite literally makes you go dumb. The Dieffenbachia contains needle-shaped oxalate crystals, which if chewed, causes a severe burning sensation in the mouth. More often than not, this unfortunate condition is mild and passes pretty quickly. But if you're a child or a pet, the situation can get pretty unpleasant. While there have been no reported cases of humans, adults, adult or children, dying due to the Diefenbachia poisoning, there have been many reported instances of animals dying due to ingesting the plant, namely dogs, cats, rabbits, and birds. So you know all the potential domestic pets. Of course, the great irony is that pronouncing the word Diefenbachia while suffering from Diefenbachia poisoning is near impossible. But even looking beyond that amusing little fact, this is not the kind of plant to let your dog or child go biting on. Give them a lettuce leaf and save yourself a trip to the hospital. Number 1. Daffodils. Do not eat the daffodil is a sentence that everybody should always say. Unfortunately, it is just not said enough. As we've seen again and again, every single part of the daffodil is toxic and inedible. In fact, you'd be surprised how many deaths in World War II resulted from eating daffodils, and I'm not joking, actually. Daffodils contain toxins known as alkaloids, in particular, lacquerine, in the daffodil bulb. This single part of the flower is more poisonous than anything in the leaves and flowers. While most people are expected to recover fairly quickly, they can prove fatal in large doses. This is why many people in World War II began consuming daffodils just for survival, only to tragically die as a result. While there may be similar flowers that are perfectly edible, the daffodil is simply one of the most toxic plants in the world. There's no real reason for people to be enthusiastically consuming daffodils by the dozens, but there's always one who just loves the taste of poison. Don't be that guy though, get something artificial like the rest of us and just enjoy the gradual blocking of your arteries. Have you ever had an unfortunate encounter with a deadly plant? Let us know in the comments. Also, check out our other cool stuff showing up on screen right now. See you next time!